Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to write T-SQL queries that include aggregates like count, sum, and average. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, I've been teasing and talking about showing you how to write T-SQL queries that include aggregates, and it's finally here. A lot of people have posted in the comments below, and I promise that I'm gonna work on responding to more of those comments. Adam and I chatted about this, and we've agreed on the day that video released, we're definitely gonna answer all those comments. And, you know, as time permits, we'll try to respond to as many as we can. All right, enough of all that. That's not why you're here. I'm going to show you how to write some queries that includes aggregates. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I'm going to start with the base query. And if you haven't been watching all of them, you should go back and watch the first one. But this is just simply a select from fact internet sales. Before you get into the aggregates, here's a web page, and I'll put the link in the description below about the different aggregate functions that support it across the different versions of SQL. There's a good list of them. If you just click on one, it'll show you the inputs that it accepts. There's two different syntaxes. There's one just for aggregation and for analytical functions. We'll talk about this in a subsequent video. We're just gonna focus on the aggregate function syntax. And you can see it accepts two optional keywords, but you must supply either an asterisk, which would be everything, or a column name. And I'll show you that in some examples here. So the first thing we wanna do is count the number of sales. So we're just gonna say count, just like that. We're gonna say num of sales. And you can use the as keyword if you want to. And so we're gonna run this, and you're gonna see, boom. 629,000 sales we've had. That's pretty simple. But what if I want to get a distinct count of all the products that were sold? So you can go count distinct, and then we're going to use our alias product key. And then we're going to change this to num products. I have an extra parentheses. I love the error checking that's built in here. And so if we run this, you'll see that I have 159 products that were sold. Not too difficult, but you may be thinking, Patrick, this is kind of basic. It is, right? But at the root of everything, it could be done pretty simply with a single table. If you wanted to sum the total sales, wait, let me show you. If you wanted to sum the total sales amount, all you do is say sum and use our alias here, sales amount as total sales. If we run this, lots and lots and lots of sales. But now you may be thinking, Patrick, I want to join to a table, and then I want to see what was the total sales amount for each product or each customer or something like that. Well, let me show you. That's pretty easy too. So I've already started writing this query right here. And you maybe remember this query from some previous videos where I'm joining to my product key. And what I want to do is, first, I want to start out by getting the total sales for each product, which will be p.english product name, and then sum s dot, there we go, and call this total sales. Now we'll run this, and we get a nice error, and it's saying, hey, this English product name is invalid in the select list because it is not contained in either an aggregate function or a group by function. So if you're not including any additional columns when you're doing your aggregate, it doesn't require a group by. But if I'm including maybe the product name, for example, and I'm not doing some type of aggregate over that column, it must be included in a group by. Remember, I'm not lazy, I'm just efficient. I'm gonna go ahead and copy this. I'm gonna say group by this. And that's all this is telling me is, hey, if you're not gonna aggregate this column, it must be included in a group by. So I'm gonna go ahead and run it. It says, hey, here's the total sales for each one of these products. Now, what I would like to do is find the product that had the most sales. And that's all you need to do is include an order by. So order by. Now you may be thinking, well, what am I gonna order by, Patrick? Well, each column is an ordinal position, and that's a one base ordinal. It's not zero. So the first column that appears in the select is one, and the second one is two, right? My aggregation is two. So I'm gonna say order by two, and by default it's going to be ascending. And so you see it starts with the smallest one. Well, I'm going to make this descending because I want to see the largest one. And so if I run this, what you'll see is, boom, mountain dash 200 silver had the most sales. That's not bad, right? That's not bad. And I can do this, I can do this pretty easy. Now let's do something more interesting. I'm gonna write a query that groups by customer name and shows me the total sales for each customer. And then I wanna find the customers that has total sales greater than 100,000. Let's see how we do that. We're gonna go here, we're gonna start fresh and clean on this new one. So let me clear these results. And so we're gonna go right here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a quick inner join, and we're gonna go to our customer on s.customer key. You guys remember all this, right? I'm gonna introduce something else, some concatenation. So in the customer, there's the first name and the plus is a concatenation key for strings. And then I'm going to use a single quote to create a space. So two single quote, space, single quote. Then I'm going to concatenate the last name. I'm going to call this customer name. And then what I'm going to do is say sum S sales amount. And this is total customer sales. Because I have these two columns and they're not included in an aggregate, I'm going to have to group by both of them, right? First name and last name. We're going to go ahead and run this now. I see all of my customer names. I've concatenated them, made it look pretty nice. And then I have all of the sales for each customer. Now I want to find the top customer. So I'm going to say order by to descending. You can see, right, Lacey Zhang has the most sales, and I've simulated some data in my AdventureWorks database. But what I want to do is I want to further limit this and only show the customers that's made sales greater than 100,000. So I can say having, and I'm going to copy this, sum greater than 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Now, if I run this, it's only going to return customers that have sales that are greater than 100,000. And I can continue, you know, I can say, you know what, make it 130. You do this, and now I can see customers that have only sales greater than 130,000. You can do the inverse. You can do different variations if you're trying to find duplicates in your table, because that group by is going to give me a distinct list of each one of those items that I'm grouping by. And then maybe I can say who has a count greater than something or something like that. All right, what do you guys think? What do you think about these aggregates in T-SQL? I hope this is interesting for you. And if you'd like me to continue, you know, this series on writing T-SQL, please let me know where. In the description, in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button, like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.